So we're back at the sawmill today. We put this little cut off piece that's 4 feet long on the mill the other day. We're going to cut it into some stickers. We're glad you stopped to see us. It's been a while since we did a sawmill video. This butt log, I think, may have come from when we saw the lap siding for the old cellar top. It's a pretty big log, probably 25 inches. Short logs are always hard to fool with. See that this one doesn't even touch that bunk. Sometime in this process, I'm going to have to slide it up there. And it's short, but it's kind of heavy. We've been running this LT15 for a while now, and I really like it. The saw head is really similar to what was on our LT35, and seems to work just fine. It's a little hard to lift. I don't know if I've got something out of whack or just a heavy head, but I'll keep tinkering with that. Maybe I can figure it out. I'll take these little flitches off and lay them on some sawhorses over there, and we'll put them back on when we make our final pass for the stickers. Well, we got it rolled up to get us a slab off the other side there, but you notice I still didn't get it on that bunk. Maybe I'll do that later. We're using Wood Mizer 747 blades. I wanted to try them, and I kind of like them, which is a good thing, because doing some snafu in the ordering process, I ended up with 35 of them. I finally got it sitting on the bunk. That'll make it a little easier to clamp and a little easier to handle all around. Well, we got a cant now. We're just starting taking off inch and an eighth boards. I like them that thick because it gives a little more room for air, and I can slide my moisture meter back in there and check one more board. Side of that cant looks awful wet. I believe maybe I'm running just a little bit too much water to cool the blade. I'll have to cut that back maybe the next time. You've almost made it halfway through. Now would be a good time to like and subscribe. I kept my little magnet from the LX55 so I could mark my lowest point on the cut sequence, and I'm using the crank to move it down an inch and an eighth, but somewhere I got lost and took it down like an inch and a quarter. That's just one, well, that's probably five stickers ruined. If you look closely, you can see that clamp is not clear down at the bottom of the cant. There's a little round spot, and I couldn't get it to clamp for the 1-inch clearance, so I'm going to have to turn that thing over here after a while. even a short log can sometimes move, as you saw. I'm going to have to take a little leveling cut to get this thing down so I can go back to cutting my inch of an eighth board. Most of that leveling came off the right side of the cant. I suppose that thing might have booed up just a little bit the way I had the clamp. Stack those boards back on there in a big heap so we can cut about 5 stickers at a time. And I move the camera around so you get a real close look where the blade cuts out. We're going to stack them on the back of the mule so we can haul them over to the old log barn and put them in so they'll dry good. I hope you've enjoyed this little video. Remember to hit the like and subscribe button. Thanks so much for coming by. We hope you'll come back again.